For slopestyle skis, it's kind of different because we're sliding rails and doing the exact opposite of what you want for skis. You're detuning your edges. So working with the Wax Tech in that event is pretty tricky. So you have to really get to know each other. I work with Dave Coombsy, or I just call him Coombs, and he gets it done somehow or some way.
Hi, I'm Dave Coombs, ski serviceman for the US Olympic slope team.
I only got introduced to Coombsy as Coombsy, and I didn't know his name was Dave for the longest time, but Coombsy's just the easiest way to talk to him. Definitely knowing the background of Coombsy and what he's done already to helping us out, it's pretty remarkable. He's got a sweet job. He gets to travel the world, hang out with cool athletes, and chill. I'm always trying to like learn more from him because I didn't grow up with that race background that he has, and that definitely is an amazing skill to have when it comes to skis and tuning.
All right.
Thanks,
smooth
man.
Smoothing and buffing for you.
Much appreciated, thank you.
I got started skiing kind of by default. My grandfather was a professor in recreation of all things. Following in his footsteps of a good, clean, you know, healthy, outdoor, active lifestyle led me to like ski racing in the beginning, just sort of took it from there. My job is equipment. It's a little bit like a downsized pit crew. I work on skis, live and breathe skiing. You know, whether I call myself a little bit of a snow scientist, I definitely know snow conditions pretty much in all corners of the world, and the waxing goes along with those varying conditions.
Just like that, ready for another day.
Thanks, Coombs.
There you go, a little shiny.
Waxing is probably the most technical thing because you have the outside air temp, the temp of the snow itself, what kind of wax you want to put, depending on that. It's a science and you just need to be good at it, and I just let him do his thing. Skiing and like competitions without Coombsy would be really hard. Just the knowledge he has of skis and the snow, just all the little things that Mother Nature brings up that you're not expecting, life would be a lot harder.
Now for the real speed of it is the base work. The base material is actually a bunch of long fibers like hair. So it becomes a little fuzzy like a scruff, and you try to cut those scruffs off. And then the waxing process traps more hair. You cut more of those off. As the work in progress sort of keeps coming, the skis just keep getting faster. So being able to feel, you know, your skis and being able to feel, you know, how the equipment really performs, and first safety, but then it's like, these skis can be the fastest. What I love about working on skis, it's a never-ending process of just really having your equipment dialed in.
When I first met Coombs, we started working with him before the 2014 Olympics. Being the first time for our sport in the Olympics, they kind of wanted to have everything secure. So he's on hill with us, he's off hill with us, working while we're sleeping or taking naps. He's in the wax room. I can drop off skis whenever. He's awesome. We work great together.
My relationship with the athletes is different than their head coaches or their technical coaches. It's a little bit on the lighter side.
Coombs is just smiling. He's like throwing up a lot of shockers. Can see him like on the jumps. You're like, Coombs. And he's like, yeah, dude. Spread the stoke to all the kids.
When I first met Devin, I knew definitely that she was an athlete at the top of the game. And just watching how she rides her ski is just an incredible, natural, gifted, super athlete. Just being part of the group, being their support staff, feeling the special moments of them going and the first time having a new sport in the Olympics can get pretty emotional at any moment.
Just leading into Sochi, just knowing that it's kind of more of a tropical place than a ski area.
What it meant for the snow being in that sort of elevation of course, it doesn't matter how much it snows, that's man-made snow. So the snow guns keep pumping. The water that's turned into snow is very dirty. That was the challenge of Sochi, was battling the dirt buildup on the skis. Devin's practices seem to go pretty smooth. Knowing about the dirt factor was shocking. Basically was scraping black sludge off the bases of their skis. So working that into the strategy, that was crucial to keep everything moving.
So for qualifiers, it got warm and my skis were good. I ended up qualifying through and we had to wait an hour, hour and a half till finals. We came off the lunch break and no one's been on the course. He was just like, I waxed everyone else. Like, how are you feeling out there? Like, do you need me to do anything? And I was like, no, I'm just gonna send it right now. Like, no turns, like, here we go. Here goes nothing, and fist pump. And then it was just like a blur.
Devin's one of my favorite athletes of all time to work with. She's a pure pro, stone-faced and very calm and collected. Go get it done, have fun. To see her get her job done, skiing hard, having fun, one of the prouder moments to have a skier that I get to work with and get to know. Stand on the podium at the Olympics, I mean, I cry every time. I could cry right now.
Seeing everyone stoked, hugs, and just celebrations. I wouldn't have been able to do it without them. And there's so much that, like, it's on us, but there's so much the team behind you that no one sees that, like, puts in all the effort that you have to really talk about, and it's because of them, like, everything happened.
Start of America. Devin Logan!
Just being able to have their back and then to see him at their most proudest moment. It's special, but I'm very humbled by being a part of it. I'm a fan in the crowd as much as anybody else. It's proud being an American, and every medal counts. USA.